What's up? It's Jasmine. Welcome back to my channel. Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing? You can't respond. I know. Let's catch up. How am I doing? The lighting is so bad. I'm so sorry. I only have 20 minutes until my next class, and I just wanted to catch up with you guys and see how everything was going and also update you guys on how I'm doing. In my last video, I took a road trip from Savannah up here to Dahlonega back to the University of North Georgia where I attend school. I'm currently a sophomore here at this senior military college, and I have been here for a week now. And let me tell you, this has been one of the most stressful weeks I had my first mental breakdown last night in the middle of the library lobby. Why? Because I make my life harder than it needs to be. Honestly, I'm just gonna be honest, I have too much going on that initially seemed like I could handle it. And now that I'm a week into it, I feel like I may have to drop a couple things just to keep my mental state in order and to be successful. You know what I mean? Like, it's better to be successful in a few things rather than fail at a lot. You know, good news is I just got my second job. My first job is an orientation leader at my university. So I help new students and transfer students adjust to the university. Now for the next 2.5 months, starting this week, I'm working in the orientation office, making up my hours that I missed. And I also got hired at Cadet Admissions a few days ago to be a student assistant. So I'm also going to be working there as an orientation leader. I'm assisting new students and transfer students adjust to the campus, and of course giving tours and whatnot virtually, and of course with COVID precautions. And then with Cadet Admissions, it's more cadet focused. In this past week that I've been back, I've had a lot of students come up to me and say like, hey, you're so, like, you're Valentine. I saw your video, like your YouTube video, the room tour, which is one of my most popular videos on my channel. One guy came up to me yesterday. No, two cadets came up to me yesterday. I was leaving the library to go to a Respect 1101 course with the Commandant of Cadets here at the university. And one of the recruits came up to me and he was like, hey, you're Valentine, right? And I was like, yes, what's up? And he was like, I saw your YouTube video. And also, you gave me a room tour back in spring before we got sent home for quarantine. I also gave a lot of room tours. Like, a lot of people saw my room as a freshman because my room was so nice. And of course, it was, besides it being really clean, it was also on the first floor, so like it's more convenient for everyone. Anyway, so one guy came up to me yesterday and he's like, hey, you gave me a room tour, and then I saw your YouTube video and I just want to say thank you. Like, it was like whatever, yada yada yada. I hear a lot of that, and it's so fantastic. But like, you guys get the gist. Like, one guy came up to me, I was covering for someone in Charlie Company. I was sitting CQ in the library, and one recruit came up to me and he said, a parade rest, all adorable. You don't have to do that in the library, because that's, if it's an academic building, you don't have to sound off, you don't have to stand a parade rest. But he stood a parade rest and he was like, Sergeant, I just want to say thank you for you making that video. I watched it over and over and over again. I was so excited to come here. But yeah, I just want to say thank you. I love the video. And like, it was just so, I was sitting there like, you're welcome. Oh my god, thank you for watching. He said over and over and over again. The amount of recruits here that came in this fall semester that have noticed me from that YouTube video is outstanding. I'm so happy to help you guys out. I don't know if anyone's watching, but like, if you guys are, I'm super happy to help. I'm glad you guys can use that as a resource. I wish I had that when I came in. I loved making the video. I love making videos. And I'm glad that it turned out to be something that was useful for you guys. Other than that, I am so stressed out. It's like one thing after another. I just can't manage my time. I always feel like I'm missing something. And it's because I hadn't really been using my planner. Once I started using my planner, though, things have been getting easier. It's just like, I'll forget that I have something going on at this time and I'll double book myself. So like, when I first got my first job, it was fine. And then when I got the second one, I actually had like my schedule like overlapped. So I was like, I can't do both at the same time. So then I figured it out yesterday. I had to sit down and it took me like 2 hours to figure that out. But I just want to be involved. I just want to, you know, I really just want to be involved. And also getting paid while being involved sign me up, especially doing something that I know can help others. Like, Cadet Admissions reached out to me and they're like, hey, we want to use your video for our university, like, spread it around, just for them to go back and hire me. Like, they literally hired me and they're like, we were super glad that you even applied. So yeah, they hired me and I'm just super excited to work with them. Of course, orientation's also a great program, and like, orientation really helps with the Cadet Admissions because they're both assisting with potential students, and of course orientation deals with current students, like people that are accepted to the university, whereas Cadet Admissions is like prospects as well as some students that may have already been accepted, but like one helps with the other. So I'm really happy about that. But I got 10 minutes until my Arabic class starts, and like I'm so tired. Can you tell? I'm breaking out. My hair looks so bad. I'm so tired. But if it's easy, it's not worth it, you know? Right now, I'm a squad leader in golf company, as well as the training NCO for golf company. And the training NCO is in charge of physical training for the company. And physical training is such a big deal in the military. It's huge. And I didn't even think about that when I applied for the spot and then I got it, and I didn't realize how big of a deal it was until I got cussed out my first day back on campus. I got cussed out day one by former drill sergeant. I skipped like 3 preparatory drills. I skipped from like the prone row to the push-up because I was just like, I don't really think we need to do the rest of these. Oh, he corrected me so fast. He was like, that's, what the, are you doing? Like, that's not the right way. You gotta do them in order. And I was just like, ah! It was more intense, I promise. This man, he is so terrifying. He's the PT advisor for my company. So that means he's the guy who's like the military leadership center staff for my company, making sure that PT is as planned and making sure like no one's getting hazed, and also making sure that PT is actually effective. It's such a big deal. If anyone watching this is interested in being a PT NCO, definitely do your research. Read the Army Doctrine FM7-22, which is the physical readiness training doctrine adopted by the Army, and like, just read it front and back. It's super helpful. The past 2 days went well. However, I have PT again on Friday, and I don't think that one's gonna go well. I can just tell it's not gonna go well. I gotta send some emails, do some homework, take a nap. I told my mom the other day, I was on the group FaceTime with my mom and my sister, and I was like, if you see me randomly like show up with everything from my dorm, like in my car, and like I just move my things back in the house, don't worry about it. That's me giving up. It's only been a week and I've already thought about like quitting. I just want to be like one or the other. Like, can I be PT NCO and just PT NCO, or can I be squad leader and just squad leader? They're like, no, you're going to be both. Not only that, but my squad is filled with I have seven subordinates directly under me, and that's fine. Once you get into a leadership position, you'll realize that not everyone that you're in charge of is as motivated as you are, or as knowledgeable as you are, or they may be more knowledgeable than you are, but just fail to obey orders, or just show up late, or just like, it's a lot. I know I sound like I'm whining, and that's because I am. My class starts in 7 minutes. But I really do appreciate you guys for listening to me rant. Also, the only reason why I'm in this car right now is because this is the only place that I have privacy. And I didn't want to rant in front of my roommates because I didn't want them to think that I'm like a baby. My roommates are great, by the way. They're super cool. I just got back on campus. This is day 7 back on campus since I've been sent home for quarantine. And I high-key want to be sent back home because of how stressed I am. It's tough, dude. I know at the end of the day it's going to be okay, and I know that I'm learning and I'm supposed to make mistakes, but I just feel like every mistake I do is just so bad, and like I'm failing everyone underneath me. Like, I don't know. I'm thinking way too hard about it, but like, I just want everything to be right, and like so far everything's just been wrong, and like nothing is going as planned. I know it'll be okay. It's just right now I'm just in that rough spot. But hey, like I said earlier, if it's tough, it's meant to, what did I say? If it's tough, it's worth it. If I do the PT NCO job correctly, I can eventually use my PT advisor, the former drill sergeant that cussed me out my first day on the job. If I do it correctly, I think I could eventually use him for recommendations if I'm applying for first sergeant board or CO board. Those are like the top positions in the company. You can also get a higher position like brigade commander, like, but the most popular ones, in my opinion, are the first sergeant and the company commander spots. So if you're first sergeant, you're the one running the company, basically. And if you're the company commander, you're the face of the company. To get those positions, you got to be up there, though. Like, there's only 8 first sergeants and only 8 company commanders here in the brigade. And there's a lot of people that want those spots. So my first sergeant, she was like, I put you there for a reason. She was like, I knew you could handle it. Here I am behind the scenes like, I can't handle it. Anyways, thank you guys for listening to me rant. I hope you guys are staying safe, practicing your social distancing, and I hope everyone's doing okay. And if you're in a hard time right now, just keep pushing, keep on keeping on. You'll see the sun shine another day. The rain will go away eventually, I promise. Like, you're gonna look back at this hard time in hindsight and be like, that wasn't that bad. Or, I'm glad that happened because I've learned something. If you don't know me by now, I apologize for introducing myself at the end of the video. But my name is Jasmine Valentine. I upload videos every Sunday and Wednesday. And if you want to join the family, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up. And I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good day!